Hello students, now we are going to learn the remaining straight lines chapter. We are now going to learn the normal form of a straight line. Abhilamba roopamlo sarala rekha samikaranam kanukundam manam. Normal form of a line. The equation of straight line whose distance from the origin is P and the normal ray of which drawn from the origin makes an angle alpha with the positive direction of x axis direction of x axis measured counterclockwise is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. Measured counterclockwise is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. ఒక సరళ రేఖ మూల బిందువు నుండి పి దూరంలో ఉండి మూల బిందువు నుండి దానికి గీసిన అభిలంబ కిరణం ధన ఎక్స్ అక్షంతో అపసవ్య దిశలో ఆల్ఫా కోణం చేస్తే ఆ సరళ రేఖ సమీకరణం ఎక్స్ కాస్ ఆల్ఫా ప్లస్ వై సైన్ ఆల్ఫా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు పి. ఇదేంటో ఇప్పుడు చూద్దాం మనం. లెట్స్ సే దిస్ ఇస్ ద కోఆర్డినేట్ యాక్సిస్, దిస్ ఇస్ ద పాజిటివ్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్, దిస్ ఇస్ ద పాజిటివ్ y axis. Let me say this is the line L. Let's say this line L is at a distance of p units from the origin. This is origin. Line L is at a distance of p units from the origin. And this is called as a normal to the line L. Let me say this is a point N, where we say n is the put the perpendicular from origin to the line. ON is called a normal to the line L. Let me say the line ON is making an angle alpha with the positive x axis in the anticlockwise direction. Then the equation of the line L is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. L అనే సరళ రేఖ మూల బిందువు నుండి p యూనిట్ దూరంలో ఉన్నది. ON అనేది L కి అభిలంబ రేఖ, మూల బిందువు నుండి గీసిన అభిలంబ రేఖ. N మూల బిందువు నుండి L కి గీసిన అభిలంబ రేఖ లంబ పాదము. ఈ ON అనే అభిలంబ రేఖ ధన x అక్షంతో ఆల్ఫా కోణం అపసవ్య దిశలో చేస్తే అప్పుడు L సరళ రేఖ సమీకరణము x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p అవుతుంది. ఇది అభిలంబ రూపము. Now let's see the proof. N is the foot of the perpendicular from origin to the line L. Let me draw a perpendicular from N onto the positive x axis. Let M be its foot of the perpendicular. N అనేది మూల బిందువు నుండి గీసిన లంబ పాదము, అభిలంబ రేఖ లంబ పాదము. సో N నుండి M అనేది NM x అక్షానికి లంబంగా గీస్తే M అనేది లంబ పాదం అవుతున్నది. ఇక్కడ మళ్ళీ ఫ్రమ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ONM cos alpha is equal to OM by ON. This is OM by ON is P. Therefore, OM is equal to P cos alpha. OM is equal to P cos alpha. Sin alpha is equal to what? Sin alpha is equal to NM by ON by ON. This is NM by P. Therefore, NM is equal to P sin alpha. This gives you N. Therefore, N is equal to N yokka X coordinate OM avutundi, Y coordinate NM avutundi. OM comma NM. This is P cos alpha comma P sin alpha. This is N. Let me find out slope of ON. Slope of ON is equal to, slope of ON is, now P, N is P cos alpha comma P sin alpha, and O, we know it is 0 comma 0. Slope of ON is P sin alpha minus 0 by P cos alpha minus 0. This is sin alpha by cos alpha. P and P gets cancelled. Sin alpha by cos alpha, this is slope of ON. This will give you slope of L. Slope of L is minus cos alpha by sin alpha. Then we'll find out equation of line L. Equation of L is y minus p sin alpha. L ane reka n ane bindu gunda pochunadi. Ippudu dani valu kuda vachindi manaki minus cos alpha by sin alpha. వాలు బిందు రూపంలో ఈ ఎల్ యొక్క సమీకరణం కనుక్కుంటున్నాము. వై మైనస్ పి సైన్ ఆల్ఫా ఇజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ కాజ్ ఆల్ఫా బై సైన్ ఆల్ఫా ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ మైనస్ పి కాజ్ ఆల్ఫా. దిస్ గివ్స్ యూ వై సైన్ ఆల్ఫా మైనస్ పి సైన్ స్క్వేర్ ఆల్ఫా ఇజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ ఎక్స్ కాజ్ ఆల్ఫా ప్లస్ పి కాస్ స్క్వేర్ ఆల్ఫా. ఓకే, నౌ when we simplify all this equation, what we get is, bring x cos alpha to LHS and p sin square alpha you take it to RHS. This will give you x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p cos square alpha plus p sin square alpha. This is p into cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. This is P into 1. So, the equation of the straight line in the normal form is X cos alpha plus Y sin alpha is equal to P. Okay? This is about the normal form of the straight line. Abhilamba roopamlo sarala rekha samikaranam X cos alpha plus Y sin alpha is equal to P avutunnadi ikkada. Next, we'll go to the next form of a straight line, that is symmetric form of a straight line. Symmetric form of a straight line. సౌష్ఠవ రూపము, సరళ రేఖ సౌష్ఠవ రూపంలో కనుక్కుంటున్నాం. రైట్, ది ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రెయిట్ లైన్ పాసింగ్ త్రూ ఎక్స్ వన్ కమా వై వన్, యు నౌ గోయింగ్ టు గో ఫర్ సిమెట్రిక్ ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ స్ట్రెయిట్ లైన్. ద స్టేట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ విచ్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రెయిట్ లైన్ పాసింగ్ త్రూ ఎక్స్ వన్ కమా వై వన్ x1 comma y1 and making an angle theta with the positive direction of the x-axis, measure counterclockwise is x minus x1 by cos theta is equal to y minus y1 by sin theta. X minus x1 by cos theta is equal to y minus y1 by sin theta. సౌష్ఠవ రూపంలో సరళ రేఖ సమీకరణము ఎక్స్ వన్ కమా వై వన్ అనే బిందువు గుండా పోతూ ఎక్స్ అక్షం ధన దిశతో తీటా కోణం చేసే సరళ రేఖ సమీకరణము ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ బై కాస్ తీటా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వై మైనస్ వై వన్ బై సైన్ తీటా అవుతున్నది. సో ది ప్రూఫ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఇన్ దిస్ మేనర్. ద స్ట్రేట్ లైన్ ఇస్ పాసింగ్ టు ది పాయింట్ ఎక్స్ వన్ కమా వై వన్ అండ్ ఇస్ మేకింగ్ అన్ యాంగిల్ తీటా విత్ ది పాజిటివ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్. When the line is making an angle theta with the positive direction of x-axis, slope of the line is tan theta. Equation of the line is, it's passing to the point x1, y1. Y minus y1 is equal to m. M is nothing but here tan theta into x minus x1. ఇది సైన్ తీటా బై కాస్ తీటా ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ అని రాసుకుంటాం. ఆన్ రీఅరేంజింగ్ ద టర్మ్స్ వై మైనస్ వై వన్ బై సైన్ తీటా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ బై కాస్ తీటా. వై మైనస్ వై వన్ బై సైన్ తీటా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ సైన్ తీటా నేను తీసుకుందాము. కాస్ తీటా ఇక్కడే ఉంటుందో ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ బై కాస్ తీటా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ వై మైనస్ వై వన్ బై సైన్ తీటా. దిస్ ఈస్ ది ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ ఇన్ ది సిమెట్రిక్ ఫామ్. సో సరళ రేఖ ధనక్షం ధనక్షంతో అపసవ్య దిశలో తీటా కోణం చేస్తుంటే ఆ సరళ రేఖ యొక్క వాలు టాన్ తీటా అవుతున్నది. మరియు ఆ సరళ రేఖ ఎక్స్ వన్ కమా వై వన్ అనే బిందువు గుండా పోతున్నది. కాబట్టి దాని సమీకరణం వై మైనస్ వై వన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు టాన్ తీటా ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్. టాన్ తీటా అంటే ఏంటి? సైన్ తీటా బై కాస్ తీటా ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్. సైన్ తీటా అని తీసుకుందాం. వై మైనస్ వై వన్ బై సైన్ తీటా ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎక్స్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ బై కాస్ తీటా. దిస్ ఇస్ ఇది సౌష్ఠవ రూపంలో సరళ రేఖ సమీకరణం. ఇప్పుడు మనము లెర్న్ హౌ టు కన్వర్ట్ ద జనరల్ ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ బివై ప్లస్ సి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో ఇంటూ వేరియస్ ఫార్మ్స్. ఏఎక్స్ ప్లస్ బివై ప్లస్ సి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో ఇస్ ద ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్. వి గోయింగ్ టు కన్వర్ట్ ఇట్ ఇంటూ స్లోప్ ఇంటర్సెప్ట్ ఫార్మ్. So slope intercept form, what is the equation of straight line in slope intercept form? It's of the type y equal to mx plus c. So our given equation is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This can be written as by is equal to minus ax minus c. Y is equal to minus ax minus c by b. This is minus a by b into x plus minus c by b. Y is equal to minus a by b into x plus minus c by b. This is how we convert the straight line into slope intercept form. Then the next form is going to be intercepts form. Our given equation is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. The intercept form of the straight line is of the type x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. So, to convert it into this form, what we do is, we take c to the other side of equal to ax plus by is equal to minus c. This gives ax by minus c plus by by minus c is equal to minus c by minus c is 1. This gives x by minus c by a plus y by minus c by b is equal to 1. This is how we convert the line into intercept form. This is slope intercept form and this is intercept form. Then we will see how to convert the line into normal form. What is the normal form of a straight line? Just now we have seen the proof. This is the line L. The line L is at a distance of p units from the origin. This is a normal to the line L. ON is normal to the line L. This normal is making an angle alpha with the positive direction of x-axis. Then the equation of this line is x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. P is the perpendicular distance of the line from the origin. P is the distance of the line from the origin. P should always be positive. So we have the general equation of the line to be as ax plus by plus C is equal to 0. To convert this line into normal form, what we do is, we always try to keep C positive. C can be either positive or negative, but we'll try to keep C positive. Down low, we'll take two cases in that. Case 1, if C is less than 0, for example, you got x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0 as the equation of a straight line. Here, C is less than 0. I told you C should be made positive. To make C positive, we'll take C to the other side of equal to. This can be written as x plus y is equal to minus of minus 1, which is going to become plus 1. Or there's no need to write minus of minus also. X plus y is equal to 1. Okay. So with reference to this, I'll show you what I wrote before. Here C is less than 0. Then AX plus BY is equal to minus C. Okay. Here X plus Y minus 1 is equal to 0. In place of C, you got minus 1. It is negative. So when you take it to the other side, it will become minus of C. Minus of minus will become positive. C is negative. Minus C will be positive. Then we divide on both sides by root A square plus B square. So then it becomes AX by root A square plus B square plus BY by root A square plus B square is equal to minus C by root A square plus B square. This is X into A by root of A square plus B square plus Y into B by root of A square plus B square is equal to minus C by root of A square plus B square. Dini, ee udaharana tho chuddam. C negative kaabatti dinni adhi vaipu teeskellam. Appudu em avutundi? C is becoming positive. Then we divide on both sides with root A square plus B square means root of A is the coefficient of X. X coefficient here is 1. Y coefficient is also 1. B is the coefficient of Y. Y coefficient is also 1. A square plus B square is 1 square plus 1 square. This is root 2. Then this becomes X plus Y by root 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. On dividing both sides with root A square plus B square, we get X plus Y by root 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. This can also be written as X into 1 by root 2 plus Y into 1 by root 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. So, we know this is the place of cause and this is the place of sign. The value which satisfies both this in terms of alpha is x cos 45 plus y sin 45 is equal to 1 by root 2. X cos 45 plus y sin 45 is equal to 1 by root 2. This is how we convert the line into the normal form. So, this is the case 1. Case 1 is C less than 0. Now, let's take case 2. What is case 2 going to be? It is C greater than 0. When C is greater than 0, what is the case going to be? Let's see. Case 2. C is greater than 0. So then AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 will be represented in this manner. We can write it in this manner. Minus AX minus BY is equal to C. As an example, let's take X plus Y plus 1 is equal to 0. In place of A, you got 1. In place of B also, you got 1. In place of C, you got 1. And this is positive. So always, the perpendicular distance from origin to the line is positive. P should be positive. To keep P positive, what I do is, I write this as minus X minus Y is equal to 1. In this equation, X and Y terms are to one side of equal to, and constant is to the other side of equal to, and that constant is positive. To make this constant positive, to keep the constant positive, I kept 1 here only. I took X and Y terms to the other side of equal to. Then, dividing with root A square plus B square means root of minus 1 whole square plus minus 1 whole square as with root 2 on both sides. We get minus X minus Y by root 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. This gives you X into minus 1 by root 2 plus Y into minus 1 by root 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. So this is the place of cause and this is the place of sign. Both sine and cos are negative. Hence theta lies in the third quadrant. And the value of theta is going to be 225 degrees. That is, x cos 225 degrees plus y sine 225 degrees is equal to 1 by root 2. Okay. Here also, when it comes to x plus b y plus c is equal to 0, as c is positive, we keep c here only, and then take these two terms to the other side, be equal to. Then it becomes minus x minus b y is equal to plus c. Dividing on both sides with root of minus a whole square plus minus b whole square, that is by root a square plus b square, we get x into minus a by root a square plus b square plus y into minus b by root a square plus b square is equal to c by root a square plus b square, which is in the form of x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. This also is in the form of x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. Here also it is in the form of x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. Okay. This is how we convert the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 into normal form. In both these examples, we see one particular thing. What is that? The perpendicular distance of the line from the origin is minus c by root a square plus b square. And here it is plus c by root of a square plus b square. That is, in place of p, we have got plus or minus c by root a square plus b square. So I can represent this as mod c by root a square plus b square. Okay. So for the general equation of line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, the perpendicular distance of this line from the origin is mod c by root a square plus b square. Mod c by root a square plus b square. How can you identify this and how can you remember this? Let's say this is 0, 0 and this is the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. I want to find out the perpendicular distance from origin to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. For that, what I do is I substitute this point 0, 0 in this expression ax plus by plus c. Perpendicular distance is mod of a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c by, I divide it with root x coefficient square plus y coefficient square, a square plus b square, which is going to be mod c by root a square plus b square. Perpendicular distance from origin to the line. So from origin we have drawn a perpendicular out of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This perpendicular distance I have to find out. How to find out this perpendicular distance? I just keep this in the expression of the equation of the line. In this expression, I keep 0, 0, a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c by, I divide it with under root x coefficient square plus y coefficient square, which is going to become mod c by under root a square plus b square. This is how we find the perpendicular distance from origin to the line. Suppose if I want to find the perpendicular distance from a point x1, y1 to the line. Distance from origin to the line, what is this equal to? Mod of c by under root x coefficient square plus y coefficient square. Okay. Now I have to find out the perpendicular distance from a point x1, y1 to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the point x1, y1 and this is the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So this perpendicular distance I have to find out. The perpendicular distance is given by the formula ax1 plus by1 plus c by under root a square plus b square. What did I do here? I substituted the point x1, y1 in the expression of the line ax1 plus by1 plus c by under root x coefficient square plus y coefficient square. This is how you can find the perpendicular distance from x1, y1 to a line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay. Now, we will get into the exercise and we'll do some problems in the exercise. Exercise 3B, first section, first problem. Exercise 3B, first section, first problem. Find the sum of the squares of the intercepts of the line. Line 4x minus 3y is equal to 12 on the axis of coordinates. Axis of coordinates. Okay, now the given line is, we'll write the solution here. The given equation of the line is, or given line is 4x minus 3y is equal to 12 The intercept form of a line is x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. To get 1 on the RHS, we divide road with 12. 4x minus 3y by 12 is equal to 12 by 12. This gives you 4x by 12 minus 3y by 12 is equal to 1. This is x by 3 plus y by minus 4 is equal to 1. This is now in the form of x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. The x intercept is 3, y intercept is minus 4. Sum of the squares of the intercepts. Sum of the square of intercepts is equal to 3 square plus minus 4 whole square. 9 plus 16, it is equal to 25. This is the first problem, first section, first problem. Let's now write the first section, fifth problem. First section, fifth problem. The intercepts of a straight line on the axis of coordinates are A and B. The intercepts of a straight line on the axis of coordinates. Are A and B. If P is the length of the perpendicular, length of perpendicular drawn from the origin to this line, write the value of P in terms of A and B. ఒక సరళ రేఖ నిరూపాక్షాల మీద చేసే అంతర్ఖండాలు ఏ కమా బి అయితే మూల బిందువు నుండి ఆ రేఖకు లంబ దూరమైన పి విలువ ఏ కమా బిలో కనుక్కోండి. ది ఇన్సెప్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ ఆన్ యాక్సిస్ ఆఫ్ కోఆర్డినేట్స్ ఆర్ ఏ అండ్ బి. సొల్యూషన్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి దిస్. యాజ్ ద స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ మేక్స్ ఇన్సెప్ట్ ఏ అండ్ బి ఆన్ ది యాక్సిస్, ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ ఇస్ equation of straight line is x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. సరళ రేఖ ఏ కమా బి అంతర్ఖండాలు చేస్తుంది అక్షాల మీద. కాబట్టి దాని సమీకరణం x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. దీన్ని ఇలా కూడా రాసుకోవచ్చు, bx plus ay by ab is equal to 1 or bx plus ay is equal to ab. This is bx plus ay minus ab is equal to 0. This is the equation of straight line. మూల బిందువు నుండి లంబ దూరం ఎంత అని ఇచ్చాడు వాడు? P అని ఇచ్చాడు. P ఇస్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద పర్పెండిక్యులర్ డ్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆరిజిన్ టు లైన్. సో గివెన్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది పర్పెండిక్యులర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆరిజిన్ టు ది లైన్ is P. Therefore, P is equal to, ipude manam chusam, perpendicular distance from origin to the line is mod C by root A square plus B square. P is equal to mod of minus AB by root of B square plus A square. X coefficient is B, Y coefficient is A. This is mod AB by root A square plus B square. This is P. Mod AB by root A square plus B square.